All right. Isaiah 61, verse 3, Jesus talking about the Spirit of the Lord is upon him. This is a prophecy that he also repeated part of it in Luke chapter 4. And it says, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion. You know, sometimes Christians mourn. Zion is talking about the church. And there's his sadness sometimes and difficulties. But he's got a plan to bring us out of that. He says, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes. So, you know, maybe your life is like an ash heap. But hey, the Lord says here, he's going to give you beauty for that ash heap. Praise God. He's going to bring you out. You're going to enjoy life more than ever before. And you're going to help others to find their way out of the ash pit too. Praise God. Give them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. Praise God. See, God will be glorified just giving praise. Let's just take a minute, just praise the Lord. Lord, we just praise you. We just praise you for your peace. We just praise you for your goodness. We just praise you for your love. We just thank you. We thank you for your anointing of peace coming upon this dear one right now in Jesus' precious name. Give us the garment of praise, hallelujah, for that spirit of heaviness in Jesus' name. Jeremiah 30, verse 17, I will restore health to thee, praise God, mental health, emotional health, emotional stability, everything, praise God. I will heal thee of thy wounds. See, maybe you've been wounded in life, praise God. But he says, I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord, because they call thee an outcast, saying, this is Zion, whom no man seeketh after. And sometimes we're wounded, we're like outcasts, but God takes you in, praise God, and gives you peace. Jeremiah 31, 3, the Lord hath appeared of old to me, saying, yea, I have loved thee with an everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness have I drawn thee. The Lord is drawing you to himself today. Matthew 11, 28 through 30, Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For I am meek and lowly of heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Lord, I take your yoke upon me. I'll learn of you, for you are meek and lowly, and I'll find rest unto my soul. Lord, I take your yoke upon me, in Jesus' name. In Matthew 18, Jesus talked about a man that was forgiven of a great debt. He asked for forgiveness of a debt, and the king forgave him. And then he went out, and he choked someone else who owed him money and tried to throw him in jail. And the Lord said to him, it says, then his Lord, after he had called him, said unto him, O thou wicked servant, I forgave thee all that debt because thou desirest me. Shouldest not thou also have had compassion on thy fellow servant, even as I had pity on thee? And his Lord was wroth and delivered him to the tormentors until he should pay all that was due to him. So likewise shall my heavenly Father do unto you, if you from your hearts forgive not every one his brother their trespasses. You know, in this message, we've been talking a lot about God's forgiveness and redemption, and you know, how he forgives even if we've done things wrong. He forgives and he has mercy. But you know what? He wants to us also to have mercy on others. And that includes those that have wronged us, those that have hurt us, maybe even a parent, a father, a mother, a sibling, a loved one that's hurt you and done you wrong. You know what? Just forgive them right now. Because otherwise, that's just a way for Satan to come and torment you. It's just an open door. And I tell you, God wants you to forgive. Just say, I forgive, Lord, and I let it go. In Jesus' precious name. And take time for this, you know, after this message is over, you know, take time just to clear your heart of any animosity, any unforgiveness towards anybody. Just be released and be free of that, because it's really a bondage for you, much more than for the other person. Just let it go and trust God and receive his forgiveness and give his forgiveness to others. Mark 11, 25 and 26, he says this same thought. And when you stand praying, forgive if you have aught against any, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses. If you do not forgive, neither will your Father, which is in heaven, forgive you your trespasses. So he says, when you're praying, just get that part straight, you know, just forgive if you have aught against anybody. Luke chapter 1, verses 78 and 79 says, through the tender mercy of God, whereby the day spring on high has visited us, to give light to them that sit in darkness and the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. Jesus came to guide your feet into the way of peace, in Jesus' name. Luke chapter 10, verses 38 through 42, talks about a certain woman named Martha, who received Jesus into her house, and she had a sister named Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. But Martha was cumbered about with much serving, and came to him and said, Lord, dost thou not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Bid her therefore that she help me. And Jesus answered and said unto her, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things, but one thing is needful, and Mary has chosen that good part which shall not be taken away from her. And that good part was sitting at Jesus' feet. So it's okay. Just take some time to be with the Lord. And don't worry about so much about what everybody else is doing. Focus on Him. Draw upon His strength. Draw upon His word, and He'll bless you.